I've seen the hot rods on TC's wall in the boardroom.
Not really. I'm not really good at like drawing cars.
And what do you draw?
Just anything. I like drawing like people and like animals and like kind of combining them.
I saw the owl. Was the owl yours?
Which one?
I think there was an owl I saw on your website, a Facebook page. It was pretty cool. Maybe it wasn't. Maybe it wasn't. I did see an owl that looked pretty cool. Maybe
I
wasn't
did an owl.
Did you do an owl?
Yeah.
I think it was you. Maybe it's your owl, but it was very, very cool. So, what time's the show? And when is it free to get in? Anybody can come by and see it.
Yeah, it's a coffee shop, the Abbey. It's from 6 to 9, and there's two other artists along with my daughter, Kayla, and I. It's Ricardo Gonzalez and Christine Benjamin, who are very great artists, and I'm just really honored to have them be a part of. It's pretty big.
It is,
you know,
big.
And I've been busy a lot, traveling, doing a lot of skating and art shows as well here and there. And I just knew that I couldn't fill the place up, so I wanted to invite some more people and you know, share the wealth as far as being able to showcase artwork for
very,
people.
Very, very cool. So listen, if you want to call in tonight to the Off the Dirt Radio Show on KSCO. The phone number here to talk to Steve Caballero or his daughter Kayla is 831-479-1080. Or you can talk to TC about his trophy.
Steve, just a question. The Abbey, for someone who doesn't know where it's at, where's it located?
I think it's located 350 Mission.
And that is, I believe it's right where Highway 1 meets Mission.
Yeah, it's connected to Vintage Faith Church. Yeah, it's 350 Mission in Santa Cruz. And it's a great coffee shop, and I think they're actually going to do an open mic there that night. Come up on stage.
Are you bringing yours? Are you because you have a musical inclination, of course.
You know what?
Which TC you should talk about?
I'm going to be behind a desk selling prints. You know, I like to bring artwork as well to sell some prints as well, as long as stuff that's on the wall.
Okay.
And I don't know if that's publicized enough, but I've been to a few events where you brought prints to sell, and people, how much are the average price of a print?
I charge $30 for the print, and they're limited. You know, I do like a run of 25, and you know, they're prints of the originals that I do, and I just wanted to kind of offer something to people so they could just kind of walk away from the show and not have to spend a couple $100 on a piece, you know. And I've found that that's worked for me. And it's made it successful for me, you know, participating in this whole adventure of being an artist.
Well, and I see how we did Board Rescue, and you brought some prints and sold them, and you sign them for them, and it's such a personal experience. So, like, anyone who's listening to the show, when you show up, they get to meet you, you sign a print for them, and we've talked about this on the show. Instagram is an important tool, and you're really good at it. And do you, I mean, it's like marketing yourself.
How do you get good at Instagram?
You know, you do it a lot. You do interesting stuff, and you do it in interesting places. You know, like, you know what I'm saying? And so you're able to share kind of your experiences. And I'm personally amazed because you're in New York one day and Australia the next.
All over the place. Listen, we got to take this call real quick. So if you want to hang on, TC. Meekster.
Hello?
Meekster, are you there?
Minky.
How are you?
Keith Meek on the phone.
Hey, I just thought I'd call, say hi, and I wanted to come down there and hang out with you, but I'm busy working on this art project.
Yeah.
For who?
For Stevie's art show on February 7th.
Where's this one at? This is not the Abbey show.
This is a week later in San Jose at a gallery called Kukui in Japantown.
Okay.
And it's going to be based on my signature shoe, the half cap.
Okay. What are you working on for him, Keith?
What's that?
What kind of artwork? What are you doing?
I'm just doing this drawing. Everything's like kind of in celebration of the half cap shoe, so I'm just doing this this drawing. I can't tell you what it is.
It's a secret? Okay. But when you were here the other day cutting that crazy commercial that we're going to have fun listening to, you said to me that you told me that you discovered Mr. Caballero. Is that a true fact?
Well, kind of. Me and Jim Martino saw him, I think, skate for the first people that kind of really saw him. I don't know. What do you think, Minky?
Yeah. Yeah, Jim and Meekster were definitely one of my first acquaintances and friends, and they had a little nickname for me.
Oh yeah, what was that nickname, Keith?
Well, the story behind it, we were sitting there and we were watching him skate the Clover Bowl, and he was tiny, you know. I mean, I was small and he was smaller than me, and we're all, well, look at this guy, he's skating pretty good. And then he did like a rollout and rolled in, which was like really insane for back then. We're all, whoa, look at this little guy. And Martino's like, man, he looks like this friend of mine named Art that snorts glue. So we called him Little Glue Man for a little while.
Little Glue Man.
Oh. Yeah, I was stoked that I had friends there. So, yeah. I was a little glue man.
Hey, Meekster, thanks for calling. Thanks for calling. Get back to work, buddy. We thank you for giving us a call. We look forward to your commercial. See you, buddy.
Later, right, Meekster.
Thanks, me and Kate.
All right, take
care. real quickly, we have on the phone right now, I think his kid's been dying to hit. Logan, he's been dying to talk to Mr. Caballero. Logan, are you there?
Yeah.
Yeah? How old are you, Logan? Are you now 9 or 10? What are you?
8.
8?
He's going backwards.
Yeah. And what do you have a question for Mr. Caballero?
Hey, Cab.
Hey, Logan.
Oh, you call him Cab. Oh, guy called Mr. Caballero. You go right to Cab.
How you doing?
Good.
Are you going to ask a question? Are we going to ask a question here?
Hey, Cab, will you help me with that set airs?
I will help you with whatever trick you want.
Wow.
But yes, and next time I see you at the skate park, just ask.
I want to see you at downtown park tomorrow, because Meester's going tomorrow with us.
He's making an appointment with you, Mr. Caballero.
Where's the one, you mean here?
No. Yeah.
Which park do you want to meet him at?
Mike Flott's.
I'm actually taking Kayla and the kids to Lake Cunningham.
You're gonna have to Instagram or Facebook him and make an appointment for that lesson. Okay, Logan.
I've seen you at Lake Cunningham.
All right, kid. Thanks for calling. Good to see you tonight.
Later, Logan.
See you, buddy.
Logan.
See you, Logan.
This is Neil TC with the Off the Rip Radio Show. We're here tonight with our distinguished guest, Mr. Steve Caballero, and his lovely daughter Kayla. We'll be right back after this commercial.
Attention all rental homeowners. Beach Nest Vacation Rentals is a proud sponsor of the Off the Lip Radio Show and is one of the fastest growing rental management companies on the Central Coast with an exquisite portfolio of family and pet friendly beach vacation rentals. Family owned and operated, they will get to know you and your every single need as a valued homeowner. Beach Nest will lovingly care and maintain your property, all the while use comprehensive business marketing strategies as well as full range of social media to maximize the desired results, especially in the off season. So give Beach Nest a call and find out what they can do for you at 831-588-6779 or visit them at beachnest.com.
We're all going on a summer holiday. No more working for a week or two. Fun and laughter on a summer holiday. No more worries for me or you.
Hi, this is Tim from De La Viga Golf Course in Santa Cruz, California. Want to play golf, but you're short on time and daylight? We have you covered with our 3, 6, and 9 short hole options. Start off 2014 with a complete golf evaluation, a swing lesson from one of our professionals, along with a complete tune-up of your clubs. We'll sharpen your game and lower your scores. We invite you to join De La Viga Golf Club, the Santa Cruz Sentinel's Reader's Choice for Best Golf Course, and take advantage of our complete 2014 tournament schedule. For further information, go to delaviegagolf.com or follow us on Facebook and Twitter, or call the golf shop at 831-423-7214.
I know a place. Ain't nobody crying.
Well, today here to talk about people's coffee. A few things. I'm Kurt, the owner. We're on 17th and Bromer, Exototal Fitness. We've been there about 6 years. I think we're making an impact in the coffee business for a couple reasons. One is our product, very consistent and becoming known throughout the community. We're a neighborhood-oriented coffee shop. I think there's too many places out there that don't care about the happiness of the customer.
Or drop in on our website at lifesabeach.com. Kick back and relax and let us do the work. And remember, no one knows the turf near the surf better. See you soon.
And we are back with the Off the Lip Radio Show on KSCO, where we ask you to listen and be heard. We are broadcasting from Santa Cruz, California.
KSCO.
That's right. We're here tonight with our guest, Mr. Steve Caballero, his daughter, Kayla. The phone number to call in, if you would like to have a, I've got a question for these, anyone here in this room, including TC, asking about his wonderful 9-foot trophy. The hell, you can
get that, I barely got it here.
Huge. Can you get that thing on the, can we get that thing on the, what are we doing? Live stream. Oh, yeah, if you want to watch us, we're on live stream. We're on the surfchannel.com. Check this thing out.
That's taller than me.
It is tall. It's taller than
me. I'm tall.
Huh? That's tall on cab.
Let's go on this camera.
Yeah, let's bring that thing. Look at the size of that thing. Rusty, don't eat it. Right now, we're going to go with your trivia.
Trivia.
Trivia brought to us by...
Sand Dollar Ding Repair.
Felix.
And I got a question for Felix tonight. When's my board ready? he actually came and picked it up. As
he's
always...
He's sick of that question.
I know.
How many times did he get asked that? When's my board ready?
Oh, man. Poor guy. But the good thing is they give him money. So that's the good
thing. That's true.
Of course, if your surfboard or paddleboard is dinged in need of some expert repair... Call Felix at Sand Dollar Ding Repair. He's got 20 years experience, Neil. Amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah, and he'll get that board fixed and in the water.
Pronto.
Correctamundo.
I have the question, too, for the trivia question. We're changing up the trivia question.
Oh, last minute change. Okay, so call Felix, 831-722-4060, dingrepair.net is his website. You can follow him on Facebook as well. And what are the prizes tonight?
We got massive prizes tonight from Surf Rider. We got a bunch of raffle tickets that are included, batch of raffle tickets that are what you will get. What's the prizes here? I can't even see this thing. I'll take my glasses off. Two custom surfboards from Natural Curves and Santa Cruz Board Makers Guild. Migration surfboards. We have an R3 wetsuit from Patagonia, custom hand planes, shaping lessons, and much more. So, like, you can win surfboards here.
So the prize tonight is a chance to win stuff.
We got two prizes. Two calls can win. If you win,
you get a chance to win
a bunch of crap.
Okay.
A bunch of great stuff from Surf Rider.
Awesome. And thanks, Surf Rider.
Yeah, we're going to thank him. So the question tonight is, TC.
Yes.
TC won that huge trophy by doing what?
Oh.
Okay.
All right.
So TC won that 9-foot trophy, taller than cab, by doing what? The phone number is call in tonight, 831-479-1080. Call a 1, call a 2, gets raffle tickets to... Prizes galore.
If you win a surfboard, that's our best raffle.
That's huge. So call in. You need to call in right away. TC won this question is, TC won the trophy for doing what, where, why, when? That's enough of the trivia question. Felix, thank you for sponsoring the show. We really appreciate it.
And now back to cab.
And get to cab. What do you got for cab?
Well, where do we start?
I have no idea.
I want to start with the Bones Brigade.
Yes, I do too.
No, it's just because, who? No one's ever asked you that question before.
Yeah.
Who's that?
You know, actually, you know what I want to talk about? First off, is Rodney Mullen as interesting as he is portrayed in that documentary?
Rodney Mullen's a genius. That's all I got to say. I mean, he invented a way for people to skateboard, which is pretty incredible. It goes far beyond just inventing a trick. I mean, he invented a way for people to have fun on skateboarding, and that takes a genius to do that.
He comes across kind of like that, you know, like it's a very mental game for him.
Yeah, he reads a lot, thinks a lot, and, you know, you have to focus, and, you know, he's proven to be a genius on and off the board. You know, when we were doing the documentary, the Bones Brigade documentary, and we were doing interviews, and you know, and we would let Rodney do all the talking, you know, because he would say the things that we would want to say out of our own mouths. Like, man, why can't I think of something like that? You know, he explains it so perfectly.
And during that time with that group of guys, and Rodney wasn't quite around as much as everybody else, but who was your favorite?
Lance Mountain. Lance Mountain was my favorite Bones Brigade guy to hang out with because he was lots of fun, and we had a lot of the same interests, you know, art and punk rock and, you know, just having fun skateboarding, traveling together, and we joke around a lot, and we tease McGill a lot.
Good old Mike McGill.
Did Rodney Mullen skate obviously differently to everybody else? It seemed like he was in a different room, as it were.
Well, he's a freestyler, you know, so they're pretty odd themselves. You know, different type of skateboarding, you know, not like, you know, riding the ramps and the bowls and everything. Just, it's flat ground, you know. Okay. But his work regimen was far beyond all of us. I mean, we would go on tour and he would go out and skate. When we got into the hotel to go to sleep, he would go out and skate at night and then come back in the middle of the night, you know, telling us he learned all these tricks, you know. So he was dedicated. I mean, his whole mind thing was about progression and creativity on the board, and after hours was his time.
TC?
Oh, getting back in the PAL, you have a world record sponsorship with PAL Peralta and George PAL. How did you maintain that for so long? This is a lesson, I think, for anybody who rides a skateboard.
Well, you know, I've been sponsored by PAL Peralta since 1979. That's when Stacy found me at a amateur contest down in San Diego. And, you know, as far as maintaining a relationship with them, you know, I just was always honored and privileged and felt very grateful that I actually got sponsored, that someone had shown some interest in what I was doing. And so I just really thought, I don't believe in natural talent. I believe that everything takes a lot of work. Hard work and you have to have a mental stability and focus to be able to maintain the success of it, you know. And everything that I've accomplished and worked for, I put a lot of time and energy in it. And if people would live in my body, they would know how much dedication I have put into it.
Well, I don't think anyone works as hard as you. I don't know everybody's work regimen, but I know I follow you on Instagram, and I'm blown away how quickly you move around.
I want to talk about Instagram for a second, because you have like a no holds barred. You lay it all out on the line on Instagram. I mean, I saw anger management classes stuff. I've seen you. There's no walls with you. Everything's on there. Is that easy for you to do?
No, it's taken work. It's taken some courage to put it all out there. And the first thing was to take my thing off of private.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to make a joke about it, but you know, it's like, it's just so weird that people have Instagram and Facebook and they're on private.
Right.
I mean, why bother?
Right.
You know, it's like my life's an open book, you know, and I just want to encourage people to come out of their shells and grow some cojones.
You can say that on the radio.
Kayla.
That's when balls in English. Yeah.
Kayla, when you see your dad saying stuff like that, is it you go, what do you think? Right on, Dad.
Yeah.
Or do you follow in that footsteps as far as you know what work you have to do in order to be successful like him?
Yeah, I understand that. Like, when I put a lot of effort into something, I usually accomplish it. And when I don't, that's when I know I'm not going to do it.
Okay.
Kayla.
She's been blowing me away with the artwork. You know, we don't live together. She lives with her mom.
Okay.
but every time she comes up with a new piece, she's gotten to a level where I was like, whoa, you're getting really good at this, you know? And there's another talent that she's put out there that I never knew about, but she can sing too. So
we got microphones.
She has all these hidden talents. Yeah. Hey, we're gonna hear a tune, all right?
All right.
Who's got a piano? Who's got a piano?
No one told her.
No, but like seriously, man. You know, I think there's so many people in this world that have talent. They're just afraid to express it.
Right.
They're living in a shell. They're insecure. They're just not tapping into their full potential as a human being. You know, and fear. And anxiety has a lot to do with that.
What do you think about when you're riding that skateboard? Is it just a part of you? What does it feel like for you to, you're as one with the board, or is a lot of words that come natural to you?
No, like I said, I don't believe in natural talent.
Right.
But what's in my mind, don't slam, don't fall, because it hurts. You know, I'm always cautious, and I respect skateboarding because I've seen a lot of people get hurt. I've gotten hurt myself. So it's always on the back of your mind, hey, you know what, this can happen. So, you know, just be careful what you're doing, but don't let it get in the way with your progression or you know,
right.
expression.
Well, that was a question I was actually going to ask you. And it's a question geared actually towards Kayla, because at the combi, you had a pretty bad fall. And you were there.
Yeah, I was judging.
Right. And so this is a double question. First off, I want to know what, Kayla, you were thinking when it happened. And just and let us know about the contest was, and I know you placed in it. And then we'll get your reaction, Steve, after as well. But what happened down there?
Oh, I don't know. I was going into the deep end, and the photographer flashed. And you know when you get flashed in the face, you can kind of still see it. So I could barely see, and I knew that I was, like, coming into the shallow end. And I don't know, I just, like, turned too much and overturned and slipped out. And when I was on the ground, all I could feel was, like, the back of my neck, like, hurting, like, really bad. And, like, my back was, like, stinging, and I just laid there. I was just like, I'm done.
And they took you out in a backboard.
Yeah.
And while that was really going on, what's going through your head when that's going on?
Honestly, I was really upset because I felt like I totally ruined the contest for everyone. Because I felt like I was, like, stalling it, mm-hmm. and I felt really bad. And that's honestly the only thing that was going through my head. I didn't really care that I fell. I was just like, oh, I feel bad, like, right. ruining it, pushing it back. I was like, oh.
Well, because it takes a little bit of time, too.
Yeah,
And then, Steve, what's going through your head?
It actually didn't take that much time. The paramedics were there really quick.
Yeah. They're on site. It's a major contest. And
well, they're right across the street.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've actually been to that hospital before once, cut my eye open, riding dirt bikes at a supercross. But they're right across the street. And when Kayla fell, you know, the medic went down there really quick, and she complained about her neck and her back, and you know, they were just really worried about it, so they called them really quick. And I mean, it really happened super quick, you know. And I think at a normal session, you know, there might have been a time where maybe she just kind of, she probably could have maybe got up, you know. But it was a contest. It was all this excitement. Everything's moving really quick. Well, you know,
right.
I ended up spending like 8 hours. You know, in the ER.
Yeah, it was more like 10 hours.
Yeah, it was like...
inside there.
You know, and they, you know, they cut up all her clothes. They did all these x-rays, and they all came up negative. You know, so it was a bad slam, but I just, you know...
And you're right. I mean, a Cunningham fall... You lay there for 15 minutes, get your marbles right. together, and then you... And so you're right. We can't have her lay there for 15 minutes.
No.
Yeah.
So it happened really quick, and you know, I just... I don't really know how the hospital works, but, you know, it took them, you know, 8 hours to tell us that we could walk out of there.
Right. they charge by the hour, Steve. Nice, they didn't tell you that?
Yeah. I was like, are we going to spend the night here? Because, like...
No, I know how it works. They charge by the hour. Stall.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, can I go back to dirt bikes for a second? You ride dirt bikes. We talked about that earlier, TC. You and I, Rob Roskopf's a mountain bike rider.
Right, yeah.
And Keith Meek's unbelievable surfer. You... are apparently unbelievable on a mountain, on a motocross bike.
Well, and like Kendall would get on a wakeboard and he was like pro in a week, you know. And so, it's not natural talent, but some people have really good balance and can visualize it, you know. And I think that's a tool that can
help. Out for your help, please subscribe to Skidmark Magazine and get on the sticker flow team for just $15.99 a year. That's only 4 cents a day. You will help rescue a Skidmark employee from poverty and help provide food, shelter, and love. Download Skidmark Magazine app on iTunes or get a paper subscription at skidmarkskatemag.com, and an employee will be given a second chance thanks to you. Right now, there is a broken, bitter employee who needs you. Please subscribe right now.
This is Susie from Flip Flop Shops in Santa Cruz, California. We carry the hottest brands and the latest styles in flip-flops and casual footwear, which include Kobian, Olukai, Reef, Quicksilver, Roxy, Cushy, Scott Hawaii, and more. Where do your flip-flops take you? Do they take you to the beach? Do they take you down the street to the local coffee shop? Do they take you to Hawaii? We have flip-flops for everyone in your family, from mom, dad, even the kiddos. We carry flip-flops with arch support. We carry flip-flops that range of very casual to very nice leather that you can wear out to dinner. If you're a Santa Cruz local or traveling to Santa Cruz to surf or skate, stop by our shop. We'll take care of you. Flip-Flop Shop Santa Cruz is located at 1528 on the legendary Pacific Avenue, downtown Santa Cruz.
Greetings, Off the Lip fans. Peter Mel here from Freeline Design Surf Shop Santa Cruz. With the holidays behind us, Freeline wants to start the year off with some good deals in 2014. We still have a great stock of high-end turbo bodyboards priced at 25% off. We also have a great collection of new surfboards starting at $399. And with over 200 boards in stock, we got lots to choose from. As always, wetsuits from Excel, O'Neill, Quicksilver, and Hotline help fill the shop. Stop by 821 41st Avenue, one block up from the Hook. Freeline Design Surf Shop, surfing Santa Cruz since 1969. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter.
We are back with the Off the Lip Radio Show. Just want to give a plug for the movie that's now shown on Netflix. And was it Sundance? And that was the Bones Brigade autobiography, which is an awesome movie.
Fantastic.
And you do not have to be a skateboarder to watch that movie. It's about a lot of things, right, Steve? I mean, you had a tear in that movie, and you were obviously drawn to tears by the fact that skateboarding has given you what you have in your life today.
Yeah. I was just kind of showing the appreciation of kind of looking back at my life and what I've accomplished and what it's given me. Definitely, I mean, everybody in this world wants to mean something to somebody or something and have a purpose, and you know, skateboarding has made a big purpose for me. And you know, getting into it, I didn't know how many people I was going to influence, you know, or encourage. And, you know, with skateboarding, like I said, to be a skateboarder, it takes a lot of not only just talent, practice, but dedication. And it's teaching you how to be, to persevere, you know. And it just shows you, when you're learning a trick, I mean, skateboarding is difficult and dangerous at the same time, but it takes a long time to learn a trick. You don't just learn them real quick. And if you can apply that same type of attitude and dedication to other things like playing music, doing art, you can be successful at pretty much anything you put your mind to.
Right.
You know, and the movie itself is just like, it's pure honesty. You know, it's pure honesty about our lives and what skateboarding did for us and how it built a generation and inspired a generation to build off of that and create a way to have a professional career. You know, we were just kind of skating for fun. There was no such thing as a professional skateboarder. There's no such thing as X Games, the internet, cell phones,
YouTube,
anything.
Right.
You know, so we were just kind of doing our thing, and little did we know, you know, years down the line, we encourage the generation.
Right. Let's talk about the half cab for a second. You want to talk about the shoe that's probably been, TCU would know, it's been one of the most successful selling shoes of all time?
Well, it's like, you know, it's the, there's like the half cab and Fender guitars, you know, that's the way I look at it. You know, it's, hold it. This is a question that I've just brought to my mind. Wasn't it on Jeopardy? Caballero was on the Jeopardy, right?
That was pretty insane. Someone texted me that and showed me that, and I was just pretty amazed at how far skateboarding has come.
He had a question on Jeopardy.
About the Caballero?
Yeah.
Wow.
And let's get back to the shoe. Recently, you just hit a milestone with the shoe, and what was that?
Two years ago. 2012 was the 20-year anniversary of my signature shoe, and it's the longest-running signature shoe in history as far as skateboarding goes.
With Vans?
With Vans shoes, and okay. It came out in 1992, and it's been in the line this whole time. And in the last years, there's been a lot of influence in other shoe companies,
okay,
kind of like copying the design. And when I saw that DC and Nike had kind of like confident. Oh, yeah. I was like, wow, that's pretty flattering.
Well, and you recently told me a story about Steve Van Doren, the founder, or him and his father, I think, right? Yeah, for the
right.
founder.
1966.
And it's almost like a father figure relationship you've had with him, huh?
Oh, I can't say. Steve Van Doren is like one of the most amazing persons in this industry, in skateboarding. He's such a giver. I mean, he loves everybody. He loves the industry. He loves skateboarding. I mean, the guy is, he's what has kept me at Vans.
Right.
You know.
And I won't talk about what we talked about because it's personal. But when you told me that story, I became a fan of that man.
Oh,
and I'm with you. And so that's an amazing thing. How many pairs of cabs do you think have been sold?
Oh, I don't know, man. I haven't kept. I have to count. Ask my accountant.
There's no hamburger counter.
Would you rather have a shoe named after you or Santa Cruz on the phone? Good evening, Peter. How are you?
Thanks. Hey, guys. I just got a couple quick questions.
Sure.
Lucy Walker has produced and directed a film called The Crash Reel, which follows the head injuries of Kevin Pierce, who is a snowboarder. And she talks about how the X Games and the sports in general in that direction have gone just a huger, bigger air. And the consequences of that kind of action. And the other thing she points out in her documentary is that action sports is woefully underinsured among the athletes. And they push these young kids higher and farther, Steve, than I'm sure even in your best days than they could have ever even imagined going. And you're talking about an injury that, was it your daughter there suffered?
Yes.
I just wondered if you could make a comment on the level and extremeness that the sports are taking right now and what you think athletes should and need to do to address that. And again, another great show, guys. Thanks.
Thanks a lot. Thanks, Pete.
Thanks, Pete.
Can I answer?
Sure, go ahead.
To be honest with you, nobody pushes us except for us. So TV doesn't push us. Companies don't push us. The individual pushes himself. So we're the ones putting our lives on the line, not the companies.
Okay. And I think kids growing up now, they just think it's normal. You know, like a 900 is just normal, you know, and there's, 10-year-olds doing 720s now, and it's just normal stuff. So that's, I think, another thing. We went to Nitro Circus. I know you went.
Yes.
And what happened there is not normal, but now it's normal. You know what I mean, Steve? You went. Talk about it.
Can we talk about it? Can we talk about it in just a second?
Sure.
I gotta go to commercial. So
darn it!
No, I'll be right back. I gotta get this thing. Hold that thought. Hang on a second, Chris. This portion of the show is brought to you by Dogman at Fine Arts. Patrick sponsors the show. We're stoked. He's at Capitola, and the Lighthouse Building's got wonderful art of surfing and T-shirts and God knows what else. If you call him up at 477-2062, he will feed you when you go down there. This is Neil T.C. Lofton, radio show on KSCO, Santa Cruz, California. Listen and be heard. Be right back after this commercial. Chill Out Cafe is the hidden gem of Pleasure Point and a proud sponsor of the Off the Lip radio show. The best place to grab some food before or after you serve. Giant burritos, piled high sandwiches, fresh salads, and piping hot coffee and chai. And my personal favorite, the delicious hot oatmeal with all the accoutrement. Come chill out at the Bright Red Surf Shack located at 860 41st Avenue, just a block from the ocean, where you'll always be welcome with a warm, friendly atmosphere and speedy service so that you won't even miss a set. So cruise down to the Chill Out Cafe, where they always roll the fatties.
Hello, I'm Schmitty of Schmitty's Custom Cabinets, Santa Cruz, California, 831-475-7809. Been in business since 1979. Few tips on saving water. Keep a 5-gallon bucket in your shower. Save the gray water from your washing machine. Reuse the water for your lawn, plants, and trees. Been doing this for 3 years. Have saved an average of 12 to 1,500 gallons per month. Just doing my part. So can you. This is Schmitty from Schmitty's Custom Cabinets, 831-475-7809. Remember to be kind. Enjoy the day.
Hey, it's TC from the Santa Cruz Boardroom. We all know the Boardroom as the best skate shop in town, but do you know the Boardroom as the best museum in town? The Boardroom currently has art on display from Jim Phillips, Steve Caballero, Jimbo Phillips, Johnny Mojo, and Brian Reed. There's 400 vintage skateboards on display and an amazing selection of vintage surfboards and snowboards for your viewing pleasure. Stop by the Santa Cruz Boardroom, pick up a t-shirt, pair of shoes, a skateboard, but come see the art. 825 41st Avenue, Santa Cruz, California, open 7 days a week.
It's Julie from Toyota Santa Cruz, and it's 2014, a new year, and we've got lots of new things happening. But the one thing that won't be new is our great customer service. We're still going to be here for you 7 days a week, sales, parts, service department, and shuttle. So Skin Dog, Stretch, Ratty, Elfin, Nelly, Meekster, come on, send some of your friends in to buy some new cars like you guys have. And make sure that you visit us on Facebook and also on our webpage at www.santacruztoyota.com, or stop by and see me at the dealership and I'll personally take care of you at Highway 1 at 41st Avenue in Capitola.
Judy from Toyota of Santa Cruz, stop by and see her. She's the best.
We are back. This is Neil and TC with the Off the Lip Radio Show. Just want to put a word of thanks out to Chris, our engineer tonight, who was stoked that he met Steve Caballero.
Yeah, he was fired up.
He was, yeah.
He's a passionate skateboarder now.
Yep, and we want to thank the guys, Roby and Justin, from Lucid Sound and Video. Is that correct?
Lucid Sound and Picture.
Lucid Sound and Picture, who are producing our show tonight. That's on thesurfchannel.com. And we'll be available shortly after the show on YouTube.
We have super producers.
We've got super producers on iTunes. We're on TuneIn. We're on offthelipradio.com. Click us on Facebook.
All right, hey, Instagram. We got to do something really quick.
Okay, go.
Hey, Cabby. Real quick about the Nitro Circus.
Nitro Circus.
How do you think about that?
Oh, my goodness. That was the most amazing show I'd ever seen in my life. And I'm around that stuff all the time. But I was super blessed to be able to bring my daughter Kayla, her friend Michael, and Caleb and Clover, they were just excited the whole time. It's a long show.
Yeah.
You know, to keep a four-year-old little girl entertained, yeah. It did.
It was good stuff. And then real quick.
Okay.
Caleb, go ahead.
What do you think about Nitro Circus?
Wow. That
graphic ever.
Caballero?
Graphic? No, any deck.
Any deck
that you've seen or come across.
Wow. I would have to say that's a hard one. I'm going to be biased here.
That's okay.
I think the Bats and Bones one, 87 Cab Dragon with the arm up
and the bat print on it.
With the bat print on the bat. Yeah.
Right.
That was my favorite. And it did really well over those years, and it's still selling now. It's one of the best reissues that there is on Palo Alto.
Awesome.
How did you feel when skateboarding art kind of came together? Skateboarding, art, punk rock, that whole ingredients came together. Did that change the sport?
You know, it all kind of meshed together, you know, kind of slowly, you know. The punk rock thing came in, you know, late 70s, early 80s, and I, you know, To be honest with you, before I got into skateboarding, I was full on disco and soul music. I lived on the east side of San Jose.
Donna Summer?
There was...
Bee Gees?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
There was, you know, Saturday Night Live. You know,
Saturday Night Fever. Right.
Yeah, and, you know, it was predominantly black and Mexican neighborhood. I mean, you know, not very many Caucasian people there. And then when I went over to the other side of town in Campbell, That's where the skateboard parks were. That's when I started listening to rock. And if it wasn't for, I wouldn't have been got into rock if it wasn't for skateboarding, because that's what they were listening to there at the park. And then that kind of transitioned to new wave, and then went into punk rock. And then when punk rock came into it, it just felt just like skateboarding. It was just free.
We're going to have you come back, talk about your music, but which punk rock bands were you in?
I was in a band called The Faction and another punk rock band called Soda.
Faction is amazing.
Okay. Google. Are you still playing music today?
I play a little bit of music with Agent Orange every once in a while when we can get a gig together. I actually played here in Santa Cruz one night.
Is that Garen's?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't announced, the show, me coming up on stage, but they invited me, and I played the whole set with them.
Okay.
Agent Orange is like the band. That's not like a garage band. That's a real deal, man. Tour bus, the whole thing. Yeah.
We were going to do a tour in Brazil, and it got canceled. I was really disappointed because I was really excited about it. But we're going to do a show in L.A. pretty soon.
Okay. I got one question left. How long does it take for you to wear out a passport?
Oh, man. Probably about a year.
That's how his life, right?
Well,
there.
This hour is going like unbelievably quickly. So we would like to, on the air, have you come back.
For sure.
And talk about 3,000 other questions that we probably have, but talk about your life. And we want to record it too, because I think down the road people are going to look back and want to hear what Steve Caballero had to say. And,
we're recording history, Neil.
Yeah, and he's an ambassador to the sport, and he's a role model for a lot of people, young and old.
You know, and a family who plays together stays together, and I'm proud of that. You have included your family in so heavily in your public life and how you travel.
Okay. Thank you.
Amazing.
And appreciate it, too.
Justin just pointed out, Bones Brigade Autobiography is on Netflix. Check it out.
It's a great film.
It's a great movie. And I watched it with my kid just recently with his buddies, and we had a great time watching it, and we were stoked on it.
Oh, and it's Saturday night at the Abbey. Come check out some artwork.
Saturday night at the Abbey. Come check out some artwork. It's in Santa Cruz on the west side on the way to UCSC. It's easy to get to.
And most importantly, bring $30 and get a signed print.
You can.
Get your picture taken with Steve. It'd be amazing.
And Kayla with her artwork.
When's Kayla going to have prints?
I actually made some prints for her.
Mr. Caballero, it was a distinguished honor for you to sit in that chair across from me and TC and have you on our show. We loved every minute of it. Kayla, thank you. We wish you all the best in your career. It was lovely to see you too. Neil and TC with Off Their Radio Show.
Kayla.
We'll see you next week with... We don't know yet.
Peace out.
It'll be exciting.